During springtime, people are taking the car again, also for leisure. Are you sure you can trust your car's battery, even when you are far from home? Do you feel the urge to buy a new one, just to be on the safe side? Then for you, I have this hack to postpone this expense and give your old battery a compact but strong assistant. That will extend the battery's life for a long time. Let's dive into a new phase for the project of video number 86. And have something that is right to put into your car. Hi, I'm Norbert, energy engineer, and I help a DIY energy enthusiast like you to take control of your energy systems. I'm very grateful for your interest in my previous video about this subject, the supercapacitors, video number 86. Where I presented a working prototype. In today's video, we are moving from this prototype to a full installation of supercapacitors in your car, with some important improvements. In the last video, we had this scheme, where the supercapacitor is directly connected to the battery, so that they together will deliver currents to the biggest consumer in your car, the cranking motor. The capacitor bank will also be recharged together with the car battery. The reason to have them together is that the supercapacitor is so much more suitable to deliver strong currents. Of course, the battery is able to do the job. It has been doing that for a century in the whole world. But it is suffering and will live much longer if it has this assistant that will easily outlive your car. In short, the supercapacitor is like a car battery, able to hold charge, but much less. From the other hand, it's able to give much more current to the starting motor in those few seconds. Afterwards, the engine will take over and drive the alternator to give all the current you want. We saw with the oscilloscope that the supercapacitor really gave a significant contribution to a starting current for a big diesel car. Today we are turning that prototype into a real-world installation. Here's what we will add. A high current rail to connect the supercapacitors between themselves and to the battery. We had unsuitable thin wiring in this prototype for the high starting current. Inductive surge protection to prevent any damage to the alternator. This is crucial because supercapacitors have a very low resistance and will ask too much current from the alternator, especially if the supercapacitors have a much lower voltage than the nominal 12 volt. Everything will be mounted on a printed circuit board or a PCB for a neat and efficient setup. On Amazon, you get many of them and even with accessories for about 10 euros. We also talk about using transistors to balance the capacitor's individual voltages and control the charging process more efficiently. And finally, you want to place it under the hood, close to the battery.
Wait a minute, somebody is calling in.
All right, I gotta ask, why are you spending all this time on DIY energy? Regular people don't care about this stuff.
That's exactly what I do. Energy independence is too important to leave to big corporations and governments. People should take control of their own energy.
Of the control? What control? Everyone just pays their bill and moves on.
And that's a problem. That bill keeps going up. It's like the lazy frogs in a pot with heating water. Why not be smart with energy and have fun at the same time?
Sounds like a hassle. I like my simple life. Flip a switch, lights go on.
Until the blackout hits, or prices double, or your government limits how much energy you may use. Wouldn't it be nice to have a backup plan?
A backup generator exists, you know.
Sure, and it doesn't feel like a thirsty camel. A home battery, solar panels, or even a DIY heat storage system would keep your home running quietly and efficiently.
You expect people to build all that? Most people can't even change a light bulb.
That's why I make these videos, to show how easy it actually is. Step by step, no expensive consultants needed.
Yeah, but isn't all this just a fad? Energy prices go up and down.
And they always stand up. The grid isn't getting stronger, while people are asking every year more from it. And also resources aren't getting cheaper. DIY energy is about future-proofing your home.
All right, let's say I believe you. What's the first thing I should do?
Start small. A plug-in solar panel. Simple, low cost, and it immediately cuts your bill. The nice thing is that while energy prices go up, the PV technology costs every year less. There you have no inflation, but deflation. And once you see the savings, you will automatically want more, and life gets exciting. If you think after this conversation that there is some point in doing things yourself, especially in energy, then please like the video, subscribe to the channel, and above all, share this with your friends and parents. That's the best way you can help me grow and continue to provide information and doing research in things that are innovative. I hope you agree with me that quite some things that I present are not on the market, but within the reach of your hands.
Let's now go into details. We are aiming for a system that works with safety and efficiently. So stick with me as I iron out the details.
One of the big challenges we face with supercapacitors in cars is managing the surge current when the alternator kicks in after cranking. Without protection, you risk damaging your alternator. Here's where inductive surge protection comes in. An inductive load is like a flywheel that doesn't allow a machine to accelerate very quickly in its speed. In the same way, this inductive load will give a resistance to each change in the current value of the alternator. So it will resist to a sudden demand of the supercapacitor. On the other hand, it will give very low resistance to a constant or slowly changing current from the alternator, which is a normal situation.
And that is what you want, because a supercapacitor is most dangerous for the alternator when it starts to deliver current. While the capacitors are low in voltage, they crave for current and may ask too much at once from the alternator. Moreover, these inductors will limit the current at the start and give also the needed time for a fuse of, I think, 120 ampere to react if needed. Because also this fuse needs some time to react, and then it can be too late. Regarding the small electronic components for balancing the capacitors, I've ordered a complete and affordable PCB kit from Amazon that I'll use to build this, and we'll make sure the surge protection is built right into the design. I'll also show you how to calculate the right components for these tasks. Every car is different, so you have to improvise. Just consider the two parts of this project as more or less separate: the supercapacitors and the electronics for balancing. The best thing is to see how these two parts can fit into your car, close to the battery. Let's go into the balancing. I had very good experience with my solutions of only two diodes. That is the LED, the LED plus the normal rectifier diode. There were several comments urging me to use more efficient and also stronger methods for deviating a current that tends to charge an individual capacitor too much. I agree that a transistor will do much more than only these two diodes, and will give it a try.
If the voltage on the capacitor becomes 2.5 volt, the LED will start to conduct and the transistor will open the gate to a much larger current that can easily flow through the resistor of 0.5 ohm. In this way, the current will be deviated from the capacitor to this resistor.
So what's next? Well, I'm working on refining the design, adding a few more components and testing it on a real car. Don't worry, I will be very careful. Now that we have a version that is actually in a car, we can try each modification and improvement immediately. In the next video, I'll show you the results of these improvements and share the final setup with you. I'm also planning a few bonus videos to explain some of the minor components and experiments with you and how they fit into the system. For example, how to charge the supercapacitors with the e-new power bank of the previous video. Next time, I will work with these transistors. They are for 5 amperes. Moreover, I want to apply these concepts also in other areas, for example in solar technology. And as always, if you have questions or remarks, let me know in the comments. Let's keep this energy movement going. As always with these kinds of projects, things don't go always according to your plan. But that's the fun of experimenting. I'll show you the results of my tests, let you know what worked and what didn't. If it doesn't work out this week, don't worry, we will keep pushing forward and keep testing and experimenting until we get it right and then showing it to you. If you like what you see and want to support this channel, please like, share and subscribe. Your support helps me to go on with these projects and sharing my results with you. Let's make sure that we are all prepared for a future with do-it-yourself energy systems. See you in the next video.